Hello everyone and welcome to How-FixIT. In this video I'm going to show you how to disassemble Dell G5 i5-87 laptop, clean it from dust and replace thermal grease. To disassemble Dell G5 you will need next tools: Phillips 1 screwdriver, plastic tool, anti-static brush, tweezers, thermal paste. In the description I leave link where to buy all necessary tools. I also recommend using magnetic mat in disassembly process and laying out each screws step by step during disassembly, which is especially useful in the case of Dell G5 5587. This laptop has a lot of screws of different size and it is very important not to confuse them during assembly. Turn the laptop over and remove screw on the bottom cover. Next, take a plastic tool and begin to open the cover. Disconnect the battery cable from the motherboard. Remove the battery and M2 SSD. Now disconnect all the cables. Let's begin to remove of upper panel on the case. This panel is quite rigidly fixed to the case, so you will have to make a little effort to remove this panel. Now remove all screws on the case. Again, take a plastic tool and open the case, separating the bottom cover from the cover with the keyboard. Now let's begin to remove of the coolant system. Pay attention to the order of removing the screws. I recommend unscrewing in the indicated order. The coolant system can be removed from the motherboard by lifting up. Remove the old thermal paste from the surface of CPU and GPU, as well as from the radiator. If thermal grease is very dry and doesn't rub well, you can use isopropyl alcohol. Now let's begin cleaning the coolant system from dust. Remove all dust from the radiator and fan. If the fan is very noisy or doesn't work at all and you need to replace the fan, you can find a compatible one for the replacement part number. And also in the description under the video I left a link where you can buy new fan for Dell G5 5587. I mainly use Arctic MX4, Noctua NTH1 or GD900. How to apply thermal grease? Apply a small amount of thermal paste to the CPU and GPU, then take a plastic tool and spread it evenly over the entire surface of the chip. If you still don't know which thermal grease to choose, in the description under the video I leave a link to where I test different thermal grease and choose the best one for laptop. How to understand if it is necessary to change the thermal pad? If the thermal pad is in elastic state, then there is no need to replace it. If the thermal pad is already wet and tough, then it needs to be replaced. Now you can install the coolant system and tighten all screws. Please notice how I tighten the screws on the radiator. It is necessary to tighten the screws evenly on each side, a few turns of each screw. If you tighten the screw immediately and completely, there is a chance that you may damage the processor chip. If your laptop is still overheating after cleaning and replacing the thermal grease, I recommend watching a video about a coolant pad for the laptop or how to undervolting CPU and GPU to reduce heat and increase laptop performance. All links you can find in the description.
Thank you.
Well, that's all. You were on HowFixit, and see you guys next time.